Hi, I'm Matthew, and we gotta get through this because I've got Cajun fish in the oven.
I want to do a Louisiana accent, and I don't know how.
I don't know either. The most I know is Gambit from X-Men.
We need to do better.
Okay, it's time.
All right. Question number one time. We've got Hanky Panky.
2000.
2000 it is.
It's number one.
Hanky Panky. If Tom Hanks wanted to remake a movie about Mintonette, which of his old movies would do the trick? Forrest Gump, Castaway, Saving Private Ryan, or The Green Mile?
I'm going to go with Castaway.
Is he right?
He is. Do you know why?
No, I don't.
Of course. Mintonette is the old-fashioned word for volleyball. And...
Oh.
Mm-hmm. So I'm talking about Wilson, but you got it, so...
Congratulations.
Yes, thank you.
Okay, well, I made this one called A Game of Romance, and for the love of Pete, I hope it's difficult.
I'm going to read
that I've been doing
things,
so well on these
which
or something.
One I want you to tell me if it.
You have been doing ridiculously well, but okay.
Clean sweeps left and right.
I'll admit this. First category is something you know. It's an American game show. The second one you don't. It's a Nora Roberts romance novel. So it's a game show or a Nora Roberts novel. $1,000 if you're right, $1,000 off if you're wrong, and away we go. Child support.
Nora.
Nope. The Joker's Wild.
Nora.
Nope. Hidden Riches.
Nora.
Yes. A Matter of Choice.
Game Show.
Nope. Three Fates.
Nora?
Yes. Snap Decision.
Game Show.
Yes. Are You the One?
Game Show.
It is. I think that was four.
I think it was four.
That's generally what you get, so... Even
so,
Steven.
We're getting there. I went from doing really well to mediocrity.
Joe, if you want him to do very badly, I bet I could come up with one.
I know, but I'm not that sadistic.
I am. Okay. And next up on our platter, we've got... Say, don't call me that anymore.
2000.
2000 it is. They don't call me that anymore. Which of these countries can still be called by the listed name? Macedonia, Swaziland, Zaire, or Myanmar?
Myanmar.
Damn.
I don't think he's correct.
You're good.
Really? I thought Zaire was still a thing, and same with Swaziland.
So, Zaire is now the Democratic Republic of Congo. Swaziland is one of the more recent ones. It is now Eswatini, officially.
And Macedonia?
North Macedonia. Greece?
I almost picked Macedonia, but...
That very recent. Greece is very protective of that name for some reason. His history
of
and
course.
Whatnot. But Myanmar, it got changed from Burma in 1989 and hasn't changed since. So, good work.
Great.
Okay, then. Personally, I think Zaire sounds better.
Yeah, it's cultural
for that now.
Thing, probably.
Yeah, anyway, next up we have Hitting the Jackpot.
I don't like the sound of this at all. We're going 2000.
2000 it is.
That means you don't like the sound of any of these questions, which I don't blame you, but...
Hitting the jackpot. In Shirley Jackson's The Lottery, what does the winner of the lottery actually win? A hanging, a beating, a stoning, or $5.
Oh boy. A hanging.
Is that correct?
Nope. The winner gets stoned to death.
Ah, dang it.
I would also like to point out that an episode of Sliders had this premise because they were doing like a Shirley Jackson tribute or something.
Fair enough.
Show is just about like, oh, slide to the left. Oh, slide to the right. Oh.
No.
I don't remember how the rest of the song goes. Everybody clap your hands.
Come on, y'all. Check it out, y'all.
I mean, here's the room I think you're in. There's a bookcase we can push on top of you.
Yeah, but good luck getting behind it. Anyway, we have Astro Boy!
1,000.
I thought so.
1,000 it is.
Ain't no jive, it's question I.
Just sound like question I today, because it glitched, but oh well.
Astro Boy! My original obsession. Astro Boy started out with Dr. Tenma mourning the loss of his only son after he died in a car accident and creating Astro Sun in his image. What was the name of Dr. Tenma's son? Akira, Daichi, Tobio, or Ichiro?
I'm gonna go with Akira.
You couldn't be more wrong. The answer is Tobio. Aww. Tobio was the name of his son, and he made Astro in his exact likeness to try and recreate his dead son, but he eventually realized that Astro couldn't be what he wanted, and so he abandoned him to Dr. O'Shea.
How much fun!
O'Shea, can you see?
I would also like to point out that
Astro's dark light was so gladly he bare. Not a boy like his song. Keep singing this song.
Anyway.
While my fish is burning.
Well, you have $2,000.
At least it's positive.
Yep.
Round one is dead to me. Oh, and by the way, all the cash in round two is doubled, in case you care about things like that. Okay, back to business.
Hey, that triangle left early today.
I know, the timing's off.
Ba-ba-ba-bum. Number six, it's.
I'm hoping for gibberish.
This means war, and not yet.
It's the...
I've actually gotten better at gibberish, so I was really hoping for it.
Anyway.
Well, you don't always get what you want.
This one's worth $10,000, as usual. List these countries based on when they joined World War II from earliest to latest. Canada, United States, Soviet Union. Soviet Union, United States, Canada, United States, Soviet Union, Canada, Soviet Union, Canada, United States, or Canada, Soviet Union, United States.
From earliest to latest?
Correct.
I'm going to go with A.
Nah.
Really?
Canada joined on September 10th, 1939, along with Britain. Russia joined on June 22nd, 1941, because Germany invaded them. And then the United States joined on the day of the Pearl Harbor attack, December 7th, 1941. So, yeah. We were late to the party.
Okay.
Yeah. Up next we have overacting, not over
4,000
it is.
Dabba dooba dabbin, question 7.
Overacting. I want to make a movie where I can play a character and one-up as many other actors who have already played the same role as possible on the big screen and small screen. Which character should I play? Dracula, Tarzan, Roy Rogers, or...
Uh, I'm gonna go with Dracula.
Is he correct?
Nope.
Was it Sherlock?
Yep.
Dang. That was a close one, honestly.
I'll admit, we kind of have to trust the Guinness World Records here, but in terms of the character that's been played the most on the screen, more than 75 actors over 254 separate times.
I am impressed.
One of them was even Neil Patrick Harris when they did a spoof of it on Doogie Howser.
I wouldn't be surprised if that counts.
It probably does.
It has to, because Neil Patrick Harris played him. The guy that played Vinny was the one for Watson.
Gotcha.
It's a torch, Watson.
Okay, next up we have Nostalgia Trip.
Oh, I hope it's a good one.
4,000.
Four it is.
It will be a good one for me.
Oh, dear.
Nostalgia Trip. This is going to be a bit of a personal question, which you should know because I've told you before. What was the first real video game that I played, not counting educational games like Jumpstart? Astro Boy Omega Factor, Buzz Lightyear of Star Command. Okay.
Yep.
You're right.
He remembered, so you didn't get him or anything.
Meanwhile, in 2009, some of us were giving miserable ladies facials.
That's an obscure reference.
And it don't sound right the way you said it.
I don't care.
What did I hit?
$6,000.
$6,000.
Was it either going to kill me or help? I just realized it might kill me.
That's up to you, right?
Yeah.
What did I hit?
What did I hit?
Alrighty, remember to buzz in on the item that correctly unites the pair on the screen. And don't forget, figure out the final bonus question, and I'll give you some extra cash.
Are you ready to go a little bit crazy?
Me too.
Let's do it.
Here we go. What you find beer in and blank rocket.
Bottle.
Yes, it is. You open it to get a breeze and blank dressing.
Window.
Ming blank and a place to store flowers. Vase, 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 whatever. Hung from Christmas trees and something to put on your hood.
Star.
No.
Really?
I don't know why you put a star on your hood.
Ornament?
Yeah, it's an ornament. Ornate light fixture and a Sia song.
Chandelier.
Good catch. A device used to smoke pot and the sound a large bell makes. Did you happen to say bong?
I did not. I was thinking of a different word.
Gotcha. Place where plants are grown and blank gases.
Greenhouse.
Yes, it is. Welcome to the bonus. Good luck with this. What all these answers have in common? Morgan Freeman movies. Books of the Bible. Things you buy for a birthday party. Things made of glass.
Glass. Thanks, man. Glass.
It is.
Yay! Great job.
Cool.
I'm proud of myself because that's the first bonus I think I've gotten on here.
And you only missed. And you only missed one of them. The bong.
Yep.
Not a bad haul.
Okay, moving along on that high, we have... Who's on what now?
4,000.
4,000 it is. Who's on what now? In Abbott and Costello's, who's on first? Who's playing shortstop? I can't read. Why today? I don't give a darn, and I don't know.
Interesting.
You've never seen this, have you?
Interesting. I don't know.
Is he correct?
Well, you don't know. It's actually, I don't give a darn.
Okay.
I had at somewhere what the rest of these people... what their positions were, but for
I know who's on first. I know who's on first. What's on second, and I don't know the rest. That's all I know.
I know, but there's someone playing every position, and I think the very last one that comes up is shortstop. So that's him. Anyway,
Jack Attack time. Soon as you see two words on the screen that go together, buzz in. 2,000 bucks if you're right, 2,000 off if you're wrong. Every time you're wrong. And careful, cause not all matches are equal. It's gotta be a match that fits this clue.
I know what this is, now I forgot what the title was. My Girl, that's right. These are songs about a particular woman, and you need to tell me who sings the song? Good luck.
Michael Jackson.
Yes, he does. That was Creedence Clearwater Revival.
Interesting. Eagles?
Nope. That was Toto.
Oh. Interesting. Weezer?
Nope.
Billy.
Fleetwood Mac.
Rod Stewart?
It is!
Nine.
Rolling Stones! Nope. was Dolly Parton.
Howdy-do.
How did I do?
Negative 4,000 by my calculation.
Oh, are you serious?
Yeah.
Yeah. Fine.
Yeah.
I had a lot of work to do to get out of the hole, and I didn't quite make it.
But still.
It was a nice attempt. Well, by the way, I figured out something I could say in a New Orleans accent.
What is that?
I guarantee you're gonna suffer.
That sounded more like Mr. T.
We're not gonna complain or criticize.
I'm not. I'm just saying that was a good Mr. T.
I'm pitiful.
Okay, we got an idea for the next big family action comedy.